surprised you're able to get out.
I was. I probably
didn't do it differently, but that's it. My boss was asking me. This is what I want to be doing anyway, so that's what I like doing.
Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to the Basilica. The Angelus Prayer, in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of the death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Praise be our Lord Jesus Christ. Nek panje pafaloni Jesus Christus. Today, during this Mass, we pray for the repose of the soul of Pope Benedict XVI. He served as the successor of Peter, leading the Church worldwide. May God grant him eternal rest. In baptism, we pass through death to new life in Christ. We live out our baptism when we love as Christ witnessed for us in his earthly life. As Jesus demonstrated through his victory over the cross and grave, participation in God's radical love is not only a duty and an honor, it is also a foretaste of the eternal kingdom. Mass today is being offered for Olive and Joseph Sade, Phil Minnick, birthday and anniversary, Pope Benedict XVI.
We begin our celebration by singing hymn number 438. Be Not Afraid, number 438 in the Breaking Bread Missal.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, welcome all of you, our parishioners, visitors, as we offer our Eucharist, the prayer of thanksgiving, perfect prayer of thanksgiving, today in a very special way for our late Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, who for many years presided over the Church, who served as the Vicar of Christ here on earth. And today we ask that God certainly welcomes him into his eternal rest, into his eternal kingdom, and give him his reward that he so rightly deserves. And so, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate this Eucharist, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie
pray. O God, faithful rewarder of souls, grant that your departed servant, Pope Benedict XVI, whom you have made successor of Peter and shepherd of your church, may happily enjoy forever in your presence in heaven the mysteries of your grace and compassion, which he faithfully ministered on earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord to whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my help. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my salvation. The Lord is my light. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my salvation. The Lord is my Why should I fear? With God I fear no one. God protects me all my life. With the Lord, what should I dread? The Lord is my light. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my salvation. There is one thing I ask of the Lord that I long for. All of my days with God to be dwelling, gazing with awe at the beauty of God, and in wonder look on God's house. The Lord is my light. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my salvation. I know I will live to see the Lord's goodness. Now in this life, I'm sure I will see it. Trust in the Lord, be strong and be brave, wait in hope for God our salvation. The Lord is my light, the Lord is my help, the Lord is my
reading from the letter to the Philippians. Though he was in the form of God, he did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave. Coming in human likeness and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that is, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Jesus Christ is Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, feed my lambs. A second time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Tend my sheep. He said to him the third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter felt hurt because he said to him the third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my sheep. Very truly, I tell you, when you were younger, you used to fasten your own belt and go wherever you wished. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will fasten a belt around you and take you where you do not wish to go. He said this to indicate the kind of death by which he would glorify God. After this, he said to him, Follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How to rise to the heights. I'll start out by saying, if not perfectly, at least broken in a broken way, Danke, Papst Benedict. I had the opportunity to watch it on his funeral on Rai Italia, or the Italian transmission of the funeral this morning at 3:30, and noted the difference between the funeral rite for Pope Benedict and St. John Paul II. There was an utter simplicity, not to say that one pope had it over the other. On the contrary, there were very significant symbols that indicated where our Holy Father Benedict was at this time in his life. And he was in retirement at the monastery just almost a year longer than he reigned as Pope. And it was a time, as he said, for total reflection. Absent from the casket this morning, and yesterday, when he was on view for the public, the Holy Father did not have the pallium, that white vestment. You might see it goes around his neck, and there are nails in it, significant of the crucifixion of Christ, Vicar of Christ. He had a very simple red cassock, chasuble. And his whole presence expressed this passionate question of Jesus to Simon Peter over 2,000 years ago. Simon, do you love me? Of course I love you, Lord. Feed my sheep. Simon, do you love me? And the scriptures even tell us how Peter became a little bit upset when Christ asked him so many times, do you love me? How many times do you have to be asked, do you love me? That means you will have to suffer for me. And Peter did, as we know, he died on the cross in an upside down manner. Blood was shed. And that, in that instance, as we see the red, symbolic of Peter's death or a martyr's death, the Holy Father, as the immediate successor of St. Peter, bore the same color in relationship to Peter 2,000 years later. And we have to admit, to have as a call at different stages of his life. He was being called by Jesus, by God, when he himself, in demeanor, in his preferences, always wanted a quiet life. He becomes an exemplar for all of us who maybe don't desire so much of a quiet life. We're active all our lives. We like to continue, and we worry about what will we do if we were in retirement. And I hope that those of us who are here, who are retired people, will appreciate that God is really giving us a wonderful opportunity to refocus on the many questions he has asked of us during our life. One time, the Holy Father said in a conference he was giving, the world was made for comfort. I want you to hear this. The world was made for comfort. But you were not. You were made for greatness. You were made for greatness. We shun those words today because we see, and the Holy Father was very, very aware of what was going on in the world. We see the turmoil that the world is in, but we also see and we hear in the church many times, as well in society, obviously, and definitely in politics. And in his encyclical, Deus Caritas, God is love, he said every nation has to have a healthy politic. That's why usually I'm reserved in saying even the word politic, but he says every nation has to have a healthy politic in order to support the greatness of its people. The greatness of its people. Kind of makes us give double thought to the present day and age. But my dear friends, obviously, as the Pope had so much time to reflect and just open his heart to God, he knew he was very, very fragile, very weak. He was humble enough, that's the thing, and I have to share, I have to confess to you, I was influenced, as many of the world were influenced, as many of the Catholics throughout the world were influenced by public notice and reference to this man, to our Holy Father Benedict, as being the Rottweiler of the Vatican. Can you imagine being called, because of his job, as it were, his call to be in charge of the doctrine, Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. It was his life's mission to protect the church, to guard the church. And when the church within the world had become a place where things just gave out over here or got weak over there, and there were different postures and different positions, you have to have someone who gently, as a shepherd, would lead the sheep back into, this is where we go, this is where we are nurtured, this is where we are nourished. And so he got this persona, this public persona of being a rather stern man. And the total opposite is true. And I fell for that image that the world was giving him. Maybe many of us did. How sad and how ashamed I am of myself to think of this saintly, holy man. In fact, it makes you wonder, how do we view humility? How do we take on humility? How do we live the greatness that we've been created to carry? And not to be like the world, but to be greater than the world says you are. We're greater because of our image and likeness of Christ. This man loved Jesus so much, so passionately. Now, if you can use your imaginations now with me. For him, the Christ was not just a spiritual thought, not a person who started this magnificent Catholic Church of ours. For him, the church is Jesus. It's almost, if you read, had an opportunity to read some of his words, it's like Benedict was taking and putting flesh on the entire global church. This is his Jesus. This is the one he loved more than anything. From the very beginning where his first encyclical is God is love, to the very end, he lived that love to show in his humility the greatness of his spirit. Whatever he desired, God stepped in. Wherever he wished to go, God stepped in. And in that moment, wherever he was called to be for the church, for the love of Jesus, for the love of Jesus, he said, Lord, you know I love you. You know everything. You know I love you. I'm saying these words to you today so that you will renew where you stand with Jesus Christ. More than church, more than faith, more than the death of this holy man. You are separate from all that when it comes to your relationship with God. If all we can seek is comfort, what happens to our greatness? That love for Jesus Christ has to far exceed every institution, every position you think you should have. Our church leaders need to know that to serve Jesus and to be in love with Jesus is greater than any position their pastoral leadership calls them to. My brothers and sisters, that love was born by the Holy Father, and you'll read volumes for a while. I hope you do. All I hope that you will take today in this celebration of his memory is that imitation of love for Jesus Christ. More than anything, more than anyone. What makes a marriage great when it comes to the fullness of love for each other? What makes the priesthood great when priests and bishops and deacons can know that above all, love for Jesus is why they were called, and that love leads them to bring the people of God closer to one another so that the very flesh of Jesus could surround them, that they really become the body of Christ. And maybe when you and I pass from this world, it's the love for Jesus Christ that's going to make us successful in anything that we do. In your retirement, love for Jesus. In your professions, in your vocations, it's going to be the love for Jesus Christ that will make it fruitful and meaningful. So that when we are taking our last breath can be something similar to Benedict XVI's last breath. He said, Ti amo Gesù, ti amo Signore. Ti amo, Signore. I love you, Lord. And then he died. I love you, Lord. Think it with me right now. In your mind, say it. I love you, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let us bring our needs of this faith community, we pray for the world, to God, our merciful Father.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For all church leaders, may the example of Jesus inspire them in humble service of love for God's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public authorities, may God lead them in working to protect the dignity and sanctity of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from doubt or despair, may the Lord open their eyes to the truth and fill them with his love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community experiencing hard times, may the Lord surround them with the support they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Benedict XVI, who served the Church as Supreme Pontiff for 8 years, that he may worship God forever in the liturgy of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The tireless efforts of Pope Benedict XVI, now called to the Lord, may bear fruit in unity, peace, and love among all men and women. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially for those for whom this Mass is being offered. For Olive and Joseph Sade, Phil Minnick on the birthday / anniversary, and for Pope Benedict XVI. And for all whose names are written in the Book of Life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now we add our own intentions in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our Father, we rejoice in your love for us. We trust that you hear and answer our prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in singing hymn number 395, Here I Am, Lord, number 395.
I will go.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and of all the souls of the Church.
We pray, O Lord, that through these devoted offices of supplication, you may mercifully bestow a blessed reward on the soul of your servant, Pope Benedict XVI, and on us your gifts of grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and her husband, Saint Joseph, and all the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all our patron saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of the whole world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Pope Francis, and Douglas Lucia, our bishop, all our bishops, all our clergy, the consecrated laity, and all your people whom you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Pope Benedict XVI, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will rise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body and blood of Christ.
Shepherd, he feeds his flock and gathers.
Please join me in the prayer for vocations found on the inside cover of your missalette. Together, please. God our Father, you send your Spirit on the apostles to continue the mission of your Son, Jesus. We pray that you will now send your Spirit on our bishops, priests, deacons, and religious, filling them with zeal to evangelize our people. We pray for all who are presently discerning your call, those in vocational formation, and those preparing them. We pray that you will bless our diocese with more priests and deacons and religious congregations with new members. Mary, our mother and patroness, intercede for us that our pastoral needs may be fulfilled through him who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Also the prayer of St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
My friends, thank you very much for your presence and your prayers today. As you know, on Thursday, immediately after Mass, we invite all of you to join in the prayer of the Divine Mercy Chaplet, the exposition and benediction of the Blessed Sacrament. Please stand, let us pray.
Renewed by the sacrament of our communion with you, O God, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Pope Benedict the 16th, who served by your will on earth, as the visible foundation of your church's unity, may be happily admitted to your blessed flock through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us kneel for the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. As we begin the chaplet of the Divine Mercy, let us pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O saving victim, you expired, Jesus, but the source of life gushed forth for souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, envelop the whole world and empty yourself out upon us. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion. For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. for the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion. For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Let us pray. Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Saint Faustina, and for the soul of Pope Benedict XVI, we pray, eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
And may the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Down in adoration, falling this great sacrament.
Given them bread from heaven,
heaven within all sweetness.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, who gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death, May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Now together let us pray the divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be his most sacred heart, blessed be his most precious blood, blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar, blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Thank you. scheduled for Saturday. Don't listen. As far as I'm concerned, I said Linda's in the morning. I don't know. Okay. Yeah, no, don't listen to him. He came over